Okay, so we have a front leg amputation on a greyhound for a distal radius osteosarcoma. We're going to do a scapulectomy. So we want to come down our scapula to the axilla. And I like to make my incision all the way around to start, just to know my landmarks. And it's just kind of a matter of working your way around. Number of small bleeders, so just having clamps on hand to kind of provide some pressure is going to help with that hemostasis. Unless you are blessed with clapping. So you want to feel down the spine of your scapula. And you're going to start excising the muscle off the spine. Hemostats are going to be your friend during this procedure. Alright. So we're kind of just going to work our way around. Fingers to bluntly dissect through a lot of this subcutaneous fat. Now sometimes I attack the front end first, sometimes I go after the underneath first. It really just depends. But you're just going to work your way around the dog. Everything is freed up. Right. So let's start working on the underneath. It's always helpful to have an assistant. The underneath is where all your important stuff is going to be. Thank you. So you kind of just isolate each muscle and go one at a time. Most of these small bleeders, I just keep a hemostat on for a little while. If there's a bit of a bigger bleeder, I'm going to go ahead and tie it off now. So this one was a little bit bigger, so we're just going to put a little circumferential around this. I'm using 2-aught monofilament absorbable. The leg a little bit to get this going. Starting to reveal the major vasculature. It's going to be in the underneath of this arm. So this is the region you want to be a little bit more careful in. Thank you. ligations in this area for these larger blood vessels. I like to do modified millers for the larger vessels. It's going to help give you a nice snug ligation. Someone want to check that? So for time's sake, I usually only ligate the vessels up against the body that are staying with the body. If they're from the leg, you're only going to get backflow. And those I tend to just put a clamp on and deal with later. So I'm just going to break these up into a couple little pieces so that we're not ligating it in one large bunch. I'm going to use aught suture for our large plexus. Expect a little bit of jumping as we are dealing with a lot of nerves in this area. Watch, make sure none of those bleed. Thank you. So now we've got most of the leg removed. Work on the back side. We've just got a little bit of attachment right at the edge of the scapula. So we've just got to work our way around. There tend to be a couple of little bleeders in here, so just watch for that. Just gonna catch them and put hemostats on them until we get all the way through. There you go, ahead and lift it up. It helps when your holder can give you some elevation. Slowly working our way, removing the muscle off the back of the scapula. do have a couple of small, like, steeping vessels, so I'm just going to put a clamp on that for a little bit, try to help with the hemostasis. So it becomes much easier once her leg is out of the way. Alright. Can we have some lidocaine, please? Do a quick survey, look for any major bleeders. We're going to do a lidocaine splash block to help. Thank you. All of our clamps are off, we have no major bleeding, so now we're going to start piecing things together. I basically start at the top and work my way down. Nice big bites. Through our muscles. Bigger bites are going to help you a little bit with hemostasis and with potential seroma formation. And muscle is not made to hold suture either. We've got a good bleeder here. So I want to make sure we tie that off before we move on. Thank you. together, pulling everything up. This point you start to realize you probably got excess skin, which is a good thing. It's rather to have better to have too much than too little. So before you start working on your sub-Qs, you kind of want to line up your skin and see how much of it you actually need and start trimming. So we've got more than enough for this skinny dog. To our sub-Qs. So I kind of do these make sure to tack everything down. You don't want any sarcoma formation. As far as drugs go, just in case anyone has those questions, we induced with, well, we pre-medded with hydroxypromazine, we induced with ketmidaz. Post-op, we send home with carprofen, gabapentin, and tramadol. We usually have them come back in about 10 to 14 days for suture removal. Thank you. the tedious task of closing. We're just going to place cruciate sutures all the way along. Although I do find when you get to the very ends where you've got that thin, floppy skin, sometimes the interrupteds are what you really need to do to get things to not crunch up. Let's find this couple of interrupteds. Makes it more cosmetic. Can someone give me a two up, please? Also, post-op, it helps to have the owners ice these for 5 minutes or so, 2 or 3 times a day. Definitely restrict activity for a couple of weeks. Thank you. clean this up and do a little glue.